Welcome back, friends. In the past few days, I'm not able to post videos frequently. Sorry for that. In my last video is I have posted. There are some seven videos. Those are 5 minutes, 10 minutes videos, which is for how to set up a billing system. There are several steps we need to follow in order to set up a billing system in your local machine. For that, I have posted 7 videos. Please follow that. Okay. Please watch those videos if you want to play with billing system. If you want to play with billing system, those videos very, very important for you. Okay. In this video, I'm going to show how to create a first user. How to create a first user. In the real scenario, let's say I installed the billing system in a particular shop. After installing, after successful setting up the billing system, I want to create one user for that shop owners. How to do that? Okay. Our billing system designed such a way we cannot access any endpoint without login. Then how do we create a user without login? That scenario, that part we're going to see part of in this video. Okay. Without creating a user, we cannot add product category, anything. Without creating a user, we cannot access any endpoint. Okay. Our system never allows without authorizing. Okay, first we need to create one authorized person. That person only can create a product, can create a category, can create a employees, vendor, customer. Okay, that part we're going to cover part of this video. Okay, let's go into the code now. I have created one controller called organization controller. In this controller method, I have created a method called saveOrg. These are REST endpoint method. Through this method, I can create a new organization. What is the purpose of this REST endpoint method? Let's say I want to deploy this billing application one medical shop. Okay. After successful deployment, now I want to enter that medical shop owner information. That is called as a organization detail. Okay. This method accept organization info as a request body. Inside this class, you can see org code, org name, then user info. Org name nothing but that medical shop name. Then we need to enter owner detail. That is who owned this medical shop. That owner information we need to enter inside a user info. Once we populated this information in the client side, I am passing this information save method, which is coming from organization service. Let's go into the method save method. The first line of this method, I am finding the user if that user associated with super role admin. If the record available in the database, the response method get populated, then I am converting that response message as a user role info. This user role info contain user ID and role ID. Okay. If the record not null, that meaning already one user exists in the database which is associated with super admin role. Okay. If any user available in the database with the super admin role, I don't want to create again. Okay, so I am throwing exception, duplicate key found exception. The super admin already created, cannot create more than one super admin. I don't want to create more than one super admin role in the billing system. Okay, this particular super admin role will have all the access. You can do anything in the application. Okay, if that particular user not available in the database, I want to create part of organization. So I'm initializing organization object. We have already organization information in the organization info object. I'm converting that organization info as a organization entity object. I'm converting organization info as a organization entity object. Then I'm generating a new code for the organization using new code method that return a one org code, that is organization code. That organization code I am setting into my entity object using set org code. Then for that user, I am sending as a user type employee. Even that user is a owner, is a employee user type. Okay. Then I'm initializing the array list. Then I'm finding super admin role object, assigning that role to the role object. I think this tooling is not required. We can comment it out because already this role is having a role name as a super admin and a role description as a super admin role. Again, I'm hard coding. I think I don't know why I'm doing this. This is an invalid code. This is an invalid code. I'm removing this. Okay. Now this role is super admin role. Okay, this role is super admin role. I'm adding that role to my role list object. Roles list object. Then that list I'm applying to user object, which is coming from organization. Now this organization having a user, that user having a super admin role. Okay. After doing this manipulation, I am passing this organization entity object to the serve method, which is coming from organization repository. After successful serve, this serve method return new organization entity object with ID, with the unique auto generation ID. Okay. I am passing this new organization object to my mapper framework. My mapper framework convert this new organization object as a organization info. Okay, then I am setting this organization info to in the response message. In the response message, then I am returning the this response message to controller class, controller method. Once returning a response message here, I am adding that response message to response entity object. Then I'm returning that response entity to the client side with status code created. Now we're going to see the demo. Before creating organization, let's try to access some endpoint. Let's see what's happening. Okay. Starting the server. Server is started now. Go to the database. Let's see here. We don't have any record in the user table. We don't have any record in user role table. We don't have any record. Then the employee table also, we don't have any record. Where is organization table? Yeah, in the organization table also, we don't have any record. Now I want to try to access some endpoint. Go to Postman. If you want to generate access token, use access token, refresh token, we need to use this endpoint, right? If you send a link, it will give error definitely. Okay. As of now, we have not created any user. Now I want to create some employees. I want to use create employee, right? Employee create request. Take this request. Then change the port name as a 9091. 9091, then add this request, send. See here, it gives clearly forbidden error, access denied. Without creating super admin role, we cannot create any user. It's saying forbidden error. Okay, for that first we need to create a super admin role through organization controller. Through that user we can create any type of users. Through that user we can access any endpoint. Let's try to access some other endpoint, like category, creating category, something like that, right? We have, yeah. Now I want to create a category. This is also giving forbidden error. Okay, forbidden error. So we cannot access any endpoint without creating a user. First we need to create a one authorized user. Now I want to create super admin user through organization controller. For that we need to use this endpoint. Method is a post method. The request, you can take it from here, or we create a request, copy this and paste it here, the request body. When you send a request, it will going to create a new organization with a user. It will create a new organization called BMB Medicals. This organization associated with this user. Once the user created, the user will have a super admin role. He can access any endpoint. He can create any user. Okay. Let's send a request. Sorry, here endpoint path is invalid. Okay, that is the reason it's giving the forbidden error. The endpoint path must be like this. Go to organization controller, API public orgs. API public orgs. You need to say API public orgs. I'm saying API public orgs. Okay, now we can access the same with the same request. So user is created. Status code is created. When you check the database, when you refresh the organization table, it has some records. Then user table, it has a records, suresh@bmp.com. User ID is a 2. When you look at user role, user ID is a 2, role ID is a 2. What is the role ID here? What is the role ID 2 here? Go to role table. The role ID 2 is super admin role. So now this user having a super admin user role. This user can do anything in the system. Okay. Now I want to access some endpoint. Before that, we need to create a JWT token. Even if it's a super admin role, we have to generate JWT access token. Through that access token only, user can access any endpoint. For that, we need to create a JWT access token. Username is suresh@bmp.com, password is 123. So I have given here suresh@bmp.com, password is 123. Using this authenticate endpoint, we can generate the access token. See, access token is generated now. I am copying this access token. Now I want to create one category. Go to category endpoint. In the header part, copy that access token. In the body, I have already given some request. Before that, we'll check the database. The category table does not have anything, right? Does not have any row. Sending request, I got the success response. Now refresh it. Now you can see the data. Through this user, we can create a employee record, customer record, vendor record also. Let's try to create one employee record. It has already request, valid request this is. Now we need to add the authorization. Bearer space access token. Now I'm sending the request. Before that, check the employee table. Okay, employee table is empty. Send the request. It gives some error, no message available. Maybe it's a wrong, wrong endpoint. This is the correct endpoint. We need to add the private, right? We need to add the private here. Private/users/employee. Now I am sending the request. See, now user is created, Bharathan Suresh. Employee code ending with 6055. See, Bharathan Suresh, employee code ending with 6055. Now, if you look at the user table, there is one more entry for bharathan@mycompany.com. Okay. Now this user can access. Now this user can access any endpoint. He can manipulate anything in our billing system. I hope you have understood how to create a user after setting up the billing system in your local machine. Okay. If you have any question, please comment me. Definitely, I'll going to help you out. In order to set up a billing system, there are 7 videos I have posted how to set up a billing system in your local machine. If you want to play with the billing system in your local machine, those 7 videos very, very important for you. Okay. Please watch those 7 videos. I have given those videos the link in the video description. In the next video, I'm going to explain about product, how to create a product. Okay. Until then, bye-bye from Suresh. Still not subscribe this channel, please subscribe it, share this video to your friend circle, click bell icon for regular updates. Thanks for watching this full video.